What's going on everybody, my name is Rico, welcome back to my channel. For those of you that are new here, my channel is about vlogs, series and tutorials. And in this episode, I'm going to show you guys 10 Lightroom tips you should know in Darktable. And the first tip of today is auto-exposing an image. When you import a RAW file into Darktable, the image is flat and dull, and then Darktable proceeds to fix the orientation by itself. It'll sharpen the image a little bit, and finally it'll add a base curve. And as you can see, the picture has become a lot more brighter than it has before. This is the original. This is with the base curve applied. And if you go to the base curve, you can see that this is the base curve. And it is based on the Nikon-like alternate. That means that the base curve has a couple of options that you can pick from. You can choose your camera and it'll adjust the base curve accordingly. But there's another way, because if you don't really like how this looks, what you can do is you can go to the sharpen one and then you go to exposure, and instead of manual you pick automatic. And now you see it has changed the exposure of the image. What you can also do, let me Control Z to undo that. Go from the base curve on and choose automatic. And now it has adjusted the image even more and it's a lot more brighter than it was before. And the histogram on the right has changed as well. Sometimes when you're not completely satisfied with your image, you hit Control Z. But if you did a lot of different changes to the image, it takes a lot of time. But there's an easier way. So let's say you want to start all over and you want to get rid of everything you've done. What you have to do is you have to delete this XMP file, and then everything you've done in Darktable will be forgotten. The second thing that you can do is reset everything you've done. So we just changed the exposure model. I'm going to hit the reset button, and as you can see, it's changed again back to the original state before the exposure was being used. So that was the base curve. Another way to do this is to just turn the module off. Then the same thing is happening. Turn it back on again. So it stores everything you've done. If you hit the reset button, everything is going back to zero. If you just turn it on and off, it saves everything you've done. And that's way easier, because if you decide that you want to use something instead of switching it off, then you don't have to go through all the right steps again to get the image exactly the way you want to. And the last and final way to do this is to just compress the history stack. So what you can do is you can go to a step of your liking, let's say the base curve. I'm going to hit compress history stack, and then everything above the base curve is going to be compressed, and this is your base again to start with. All those sidebars in Darktable, to the top, to the left, to the right, to the bottom, I should make a wrap out of that, can be very distracting, and there's an easy way to get around it, to just focus on the image. So you've done a lot of edits. I haven't on this picture, but let's pretend you have. You've done a lot of edits and you just want to see the image, because everything here is very, very distracting to you. All you have to do is press Z and hold it, and then you will see the entire image without all the sidebars. If you want to see your sidebars again, all you have to do is release the Z button and everything goes back to normal. What you can also do is hit Alt-1, it'll zoom in 100%. Hit it again, it'll zoom in 200%. And if you hit Alt-3, it'll go back to the original state you were working with. And the following tip is about orientation. In the crop and rotate module in Darktable, you can choose several grids. Mine is now set to grid or several guides. You can change it to the rules of thirds, you can change it to perspective, and you can change it to metering or any other one you like. And that basically allows you to have a quick look at your image and see how you want to compose your image. Now, there's nothing worse than a picture that's a bit off, you know, like the horizon is a bit crooked. It's a difference between having a good image and having an image you go like, ah, I'm not quite sure. But it's easy to fix. Darktable has two ways to do this. The first one is the perspective module, and the second one is the crop and rotate module. And that's what this tip is about. Darktable has its own crop and rotate module. If you open it up, you won't see anything just yet, but what you can do is go to guides, and then put it on grid, you will see a lot of horizontal lines and vertical lines. Now what we can clearly see is that the horizon is off. An easy way to do this with the crop and rotate module is to use the keystone method. Click on keystone, pick horizontal, and then grab this point, put it over here, and grab this point and put it on the same line that you want to straighten out. Hit the link button so both of these lines are connected to one another. Hit the OK button, and now you'll see that the image has been straightened out. But as you can see, the perspective has changed. So now what you need to do is you need to crop the image to a size where it looks good. So I think I'll go with this and then double click it, and there you go. Now you've got a somewhat smaller image, but the horizon is nice and straight. Sometimes you want to see in between what you've done. So that's what the next tip is about. It's going to show you how to do the before and after. Darktable has an awesome way of showing you the before and after. All you have to do is take a snapshot. This is a picture I've edited before. Then choose the snapshot, press the original, and then there you have it. This is the original image, and this is the image after I've done an edit of it. And as you can see, it's very easy to see what your original picture was and what your new picture is. Sometimes when you start with an image, your highlights are very blown out, the darks are very crushed. Darktable has a module that allows you to show what's being blown out and what's being crushed. You can check and see which part is overexposed and which part is underexposed in two ways. First one is to just hit O, and then as you can see, what's overexposed is red and what's underexposed is blue. Basically, the highlights are blown out here and the blacks are being crushed. And there's another way to do this, which is just press this symbol right here and then it'll toggle on and off as well. And then you know which part of your image you have to fix. To emphasize something in an image, there are a couple of ways. One of them is to create a vignette, but Darktable allows you to do something else. Let's go to the next tip. And for this part, we are using this lovely model over here. We are going to start with the exposure module. If you already have an exposure model because you've tweaked something in the image, all you have to do is press the symbol right here, go to new instance, and then you see another exposure module being opened. We need to use a mask to emphasize the focus on our face. So we are going to blend, drawn mask, and I want something that resembles her face. So I'll use the ellipse tool. Click it, and now what you can do is you can decrease this or increase the size or however you like. Same with this point as well. Increase, decrease. Let's just make it like this. There we go. Now we are going to put the mask blur on 100. There we go. And we are going to put the mask contrast on half a point. And you can do that by right clicking your mouse button, then just fill in the width, hit enter. Nothing has changed just yet, but it will, because we are going to invert the mask. And now we are going to decrease the exposure to about this. That looks good. So I want to decrease this just like that. There we go. And now as you can see, her face stayed nice and bright and everything else became dark. So the focus is immediately being drawn to her face. One of the most important things when editing a picture or a movie or whatever you're going to do is organization. And that's what this tip is about. Lighttable allows you to organize your pictures very well. You can give them certain stars. So let's say I'll give two pictures 5 stars. And I just want to see those. I'm going to click this one. And now I see the two pictures that I've given 5 stars. Let's go back to the all of them. And now what you can do as well is you can use several styles that you've made and apply the style to all of the pictures. So let's see how that works. I'm going to click this one, hold shift, click that one. Now I've got the top 5 selected. I'm going to double click on winter glow. We're going to wait. And there you have it. Now all of these 5 pictures have the same style that I've just used. Same if I use the orange and teal one. It doesn't matter which one you use. As you can see, the image has changed again and they all got the same style. If you guys are still here, I salute you. It's been a very long video so far, but trust me, we're almost there. I got one final tip, which has to do with the metadata of a picture. In the light table menu of Darktable, you have a few modules on your right. One is the metadata editor. You can choose and pick which one you want to edit. You can give it a title. You can give it a description, say who the creator is, say who the publisher is. You can state if there's a copyright on it. And you can also, what I've showed you before, apply the same style to all the pictures that you want or all the pictures that you select. It will also allow you to remove or to move pictures. And what you can also do is add a GPX track file to your images so you'll know where they have been taken. And obviously you can export everything that you've created in the darkroom. So basically when you're editing a picture like this, this is the HDR that's been created and you want to export this, all you have to do is go to the light table, then hit export selected, and then it'll be exported. Or what you can do is you can press Control E and it'll export automatically into the destination folder.